taught me everything, and everything you've given me, I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life, yeah. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. Ooh. You were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time. Mama, mama, you know I love you. Ooh, you knew I love you, mama. Mama, you're the queen of my heart. Your love is like tears from the stars.
Yes, it is.
Mama, I just want you to know, loving you is like food to my soul.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
You're always down for me, have always been around for me, even when I was bad. You've shown me right from my wrongs. Yes, you did. And you took up for me when everyone was down on me. You always did understand. You gave me strength to go on.
Tell you something about the favor of God. You can't earn the favor of God. God just does what he does, whether you like it or not. And in that same instance, the Lord touched the heart of that woman. I guess she was a social worker or whoever she was. And she let her go in to see me. And the woman was saying, now that's it. That's all that can be done. And we're going to have to send you grandbaby off. But God is a God who turns the heart of the king and makes him do what he desires. And the woman had compassion on my grandmother 44 years ago and said, lady, I'm going to tell you something. I want you and that baby. I'm going to turn my back. And when I turn my back, you and that baby better be gone. My grandmother stole me. And I really want you to hear what I'm about to say. I'm convinced that all things work together for the good of them, for those who love God and those who are called according to his purposes. And never judge a thing because it starts out bad. Have I got any witnesses? There's some of us in this room right now, people didn't think you were going to make it, and here you are today. But it is all about God's plans and God's purposes. And isn't it amazing how the Lord worked where he kept me in the family?
Amen.
My grandfather, J.B., has gone on to be with the Lord. But one of the things I remember growing up, that he would always somehow or another mysteriously show up to my church. And he had a habit of bringing me silver dollars. And he said, you know, I'm your grandpa. And just as he would appear, he disappeared. But I will remember my 16th birthday is when I really got to meet this woman, really, with all of my heart and my soul. And she began to relay the story that I relayed to you. Here I am today, a bishop in the Lord's church and about to leave California. Relocating to New Orleans, Louisiana. I got a brand new assignment. But it is because of her obedience and boldness. Let me tell you something. God don't use perfect people. He uses folk who are messed up, who are just like you and me. Now, you know, some folk, they got quiet right there because they don't believe they're messed up. But I want you to know, listen to me. One out of every five persons suffers from mental illness. So if you count on your table, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, my two youngest children are here, her great-grandchildren, and it's a blessing to have two great names as a part of my heritage. I thank God for the name Adams. Dr. W.T. Adams raised me as his own son, but I thank God also that I am a Westbrook. Thank God.
Can the church say amen? One more time.
Amen.
That's my big cousin. And all the women said about my grandmother, this woman is love. She is love, and I'm not talking about some romantic emotion. But love is responsibility. Love is commitment. Love is sacrifice. Love is long-suffering. And most of all, love is duty. And this woman has performed an enormous duty for me. She has housed the homeless. She has fed the hungry. There's many people who have lived right at 1349 Avenue in these homes. Love is action. So if you love, then that requires action. And she has been a woman of action all of my life. And I thank God for her. Grandma, I love you. Happy 90th birthday. So we want to keep the program moving right along with some historical reflection from Mrs. Carol Curtis, Westbrooks Curtis.
Oh, Morton, she beat anybody else. And we taught, we learned all the rules. And if we had a teacher to everybody else, because if they got in trouble, we got them.
Amen.
That's right.
Yeah. If something happened to them that they caused, we got them.
Come on over.
But that's the fight for older children, and I am her oldest daughter. I want you guys to pay attention because I want to do a little historical preview of what was going on when Mama was born. January 12, 1915, the House of Representatives rejected the proposal to give women the right to vote. Ladies, I know she must have been marching when she was five so she could vote. January 25th, at Alexander Graham Bell in North New York City, called Thomas Watson in San Francisco, the first phone call. Can you today, in the light of cell phone mania, imagine a world with no telephones? February 23rd, 1915, Nevada enforces the convenient divorce law. I think that means we were free. We had to stay married to the nuts.
Come on.
April 5th, Jess Willard knocked out Jack Johnson for the heavyweight boxing title of the world. May 17th, James, Union Star Baptist Convention started May 17th, 1915. was chartered. Sure, my cousin Wanda would know that. May 24th, 1915, Thomas Edison invents transcribe to record to the telephone. So that means the Western Union. All these things were part of her history. She's lived through 15 presidents. Can you imagine? All the ones that stormed the White House, most of them are dead, and she is still here. Now I want to tell you a little bit about Vi's personal history. She was born in a little place called, it was Gilgal. That was a little spin through outside of Jasper. She said Jasper because that was the big town. You know, if you know anything about Texas, you got all these little spin through places. Fairview, Beulah, Cause. Mama was born in Gilgal, and that's somewhere near Old Blocks. Gwen, you know anything about Old Blocks? Virgil?
Me either.
Well, she told me the story, and I think my mom knows everything. Anyway, she was born to Sam Adams, who, incidentally, James, is the uncle of W.T. Adams, and Bertha Grisby Adams. She was raised mostly by her grandparents, Nathaniel Adams, and listen to this name, Emily Mary Martha Wayne Doodle Breed. That was her grandmother, Adams. She was Choctaw, and her grandfather, Matt Adams, was Caucasian and African. And on her mother's side, her grandfather was Caucasian and African, and his name was Sam Grisby, and her grandmother's name was Fanny Grisby, and she was Blackfoot Indian and African. So when she starts doing those little war dances, you kind of know where she gets them from. But she told me lots of stories about her grandma Emily. Grandma Emily was a faithful praying woman, and she was earthy, like most Indians were. She didn't believe in prescription medicine or anything store-bought. She would go to the woods and pick roots and berries and plants to heal her family. My mother was stricken with typhoid malaria fever when she was a little girl, about 9 or 10. And the doctor told her that she would not live. Well, the doctor's dead and mama's still here. Grandma Emily doctored on her, and my mother said when she walked the floor, her dress would drag the floor and she would be talking to the Lord. And so my mother was healed of that. She had to learn how to walk all over again. In 1932-33, she married J.D. Westbrooks. My mother had 8 siblings. Estella was her oldest sister, Mineola next to her, Henry or Mrs. Gill, Willie Arthoria, Naomi, and Clarence Jean. Grandma Burke married Willie Westbrooks. So a lot of you, we're twice kin to you because my step-grandfather was a Westbrooks also. That's how she come to meet J.D. Westbrooks, and he stole her heart, and they married in 1933. And this is the result. 5 children and thousands of miles from her beginning. Vi ended in California. And what I think about my mother's history is that she's courageous, because I live 10 blocks from her, and I've lived there 34 years, and I'll probably still live there for the rest of my life, because I don't have the courage to move that far from my family. But she moved to California in a time when there were not telephones, and they were writing letters, or they were so spiritual that they would pray. And when they needed to hear from somebody, mm-hmm. or someone needed to hear from them, they were filled in their spirits. What a God we serve. I think that we've gotten so sophisticated with our cell phones and computers that we've forgotten our basics. That the Spirit of God dwells within you, and it keeps us connected. Anyway, once Mama moved to Texas, she worked. She's been through three wars, World War I, World War II, the Korean War, now the Iran-Contra, the Vietnam War, Afghanistan, and she's still here. And I like it because that's a lot of living. What I gained from my mother is in her journey. She always worked. She used to press hair in Texas for 50 cents a head. That was good money then. She came to California. She was a ship scaler at Moore's Shipyard during World War II. She worked at many of the hotels around then. Hillcastle Hotel as a maid. Some of the rich white families in the area she worked as a maid. And my mother has excellent entertainment skills. She always set our table for her children and fixed us the best of meals. We were poor. Yeah. I said poor because it didn't have a bar. We were poor. But my mother could take something, almost make nothing into something sumptuous and filling. We were never hungry. Yeah, chicken feet. Anything. But we were never hungry, and she always managed to have a little extra to feed someone else. I remember one Thanksgiving that she cut our turkey in half. The girl said, "Bob, what you cut our turkey in half for?" But the neighbor next door had four children.
Yeah, right.
No, her husband wasn't doing very well. And she shared our Thanksgiving dinner with that, like Butch shared before. So that her example of giving fell on all of us, and I'm very thankful of that. Her example of prayer, when I was a little girl, my grandmama introduced me to Christ. And my mother would gather us around her bed, and each one of us would have to pray. There's value in teaching your children to pray. I am 60 years old, and I still pray because of what my mother instilled in me through her faithfulness to God. And I've come through many storms prayerfully because of her. So I'm more than grateful for that. My mother went back to school at 51 years old. At 51 years old, gained a certificate of completion at Laney College for home health care. She worked in many homes in Oakland, and she worked at Highland Hospital for a time. I forgot one thing in her history. During World War II, the soldiers would come to Oakland Hospital. And my mother and a group of women would go there and minister to them and pray with them. And she told me how they would cry and they were away from home, but those women would walk and pray with them. And that's where she met Eleanor Roosevelt. So she has done a whole lot for many in her whole life. And I know she's not boastful about it, but I know she can say, if I look back over my life, I have a testimony. So as a part of her history, I would like to read this. I'm going to read you the poem called An Empty Plate. Because through my lifetime, many times when my mother was raising us, we wouldn't have enough in the pot for everybody. And what she would do is fill our plates up and wait till we finish eating and then scrape the scraps, hallelujah, off the plate, hallelujah, and eat our scraps. What I saw as empty was filled with love and hope. So all that I want her to pass to me is her empty plate. because it showed me how to share, it showed me how to nurture and be a mother. It showed me how to tell my kids, well, you wrong. Mm-hmm. I'm your mama.
That's right.
If I don't tell you you're wrong, no one else cares enough to. So I thank you, Mama, for all the hard lessons, for the rich history, and for setting a goal that I'm constantly trying to attain to. That's her history. Mama.
I remember sitting around the house after all our little bellies were fed. Everyone would be settled back and listening to what Grandma said. She said, come gather round you chillin', I'm gonna tell you what I hold dear. Gonna tell you about the gracious life of a pioneer. See, God's always had his hands around them, so when they leave, there's no need to mourn. He sent them here to save a place for the children being born. When you see the pioneer,
but I also played an important part in my life because I stayed on 51st and I spent a lot of time at her house growing up as a kid. And I just wanted to sing a little something before I go and check on my mother, because my mother, I had to take her to the hospital this morning because of her cancer. So I wanted to come and at least let her know that I love her in spite of what I'm going through. She still has joy. She still has joy. After all that she has been through, she still has joy. She still has joy. She still has joy. After all that she has been through, she still has joy. She still has peace.
Yes.
You still have peace. Yes. After all that you have been through, you still have peace. Yes. 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 After all that you have been through,
yes.
You still have peace. You still have love. You still have love. After all that you have been through, you still have love. You still.
Brothers and sisters, dear family, I'd like to present to you Mr. Leonard Wilson, song of tribute by Vidalia Westbrooks. Thank you. There are five children. We not live life by the grace of God. I have gone through my trials and tribulations, so I know there is a God. I had an accident about 8 years ago that left me with a spinal cord injury, terrible injury, a broken neck. They told me, go find a rest home, you'll never walk again. First thing I did is fire that doctor. Second thing I did is start praying to God that everything would be okay. And after 5 years, I did walk again. And then after 5 more years, I was able to do other things again. So I owe everything to God, and I know that's right. But the reason why I have them all down here is for one reason. And that is, we did everything today but commemorate this lady. So I told Don last night that I did something very special for this family. And I'd like you to know that this is a toast that was given to me when I was 10 years old by my grandfather. And what I'd like you to do is listen to it very closely, because the first thing you're gonna do is say, what is he talking about? Who is this man? But listen to it very closely. It's a riddle inside of a toast. Lorenzo, can you get that bag there, please? And give each one of those people standing right there one of those. I had the plaque made up for Mother Westbrook, and then I had five plaques made for each one of the children. It goes like this. Here's to the very best years of my life, spent in the arms of another man's wife, my mother. Happy birthday, 90th, Mother Westbrook from L.K. Wilson, along with your sons, daughters, family, and friends. Now, here's the riddle. Who was the man? Their father. It says, here's to the very best years of my life, spent in the arms of another man's wife, my mother. I'd like to commemorate this day to Mrs. Westbrook and let her know that I love her very, very much. I haven't been around her a lot of times in my life, but I was around her enough. She just don't remember me, but I was around. She kicked me out of that house a few times. Okay, and this is... I'd like to do this, and I'd like them to be standing right beside their mother when I sing this. Now look, do me a favor. I only need this one favor, because it's really, really important that everyone in this room become silent right now, because the words of this song is too important for you not to listen to. I got this song from Lou Rawls about 20 years ago, and it's one of my favorites. It's simply called Old Folks. Goes like this. Everyone knows him as old folks. Everyone knows him as old folks. I got it right now. Like the seasons, they come and they go. Free as a bird and as good as their word. That's why we all love them so. Always leaving a spoon in their coffee. They might tuck a napkin up under their chin. Some smoke an old corn cob pipe, so mellow and ripe. You needn't be ashamed of them. Every Friday, they might go fishing down by the lake, and they might only catch a perch or two and say a great big old whale got away. Well, I guess I'll warm up the stage. Oh, but someday there won't be no more. Oh. And what a lonesome old town this is gonna be. Children's voices at play, they all will be silent one day. The day that they take over, the day they're gonna take old folks away. Now, this is my last tribute, and we'll be finished. Don called me about 2 weeks ago, and he told me, he said, LK, my mother is turning 90 years old on her next birthday. And he said, I've heard you sing a song that's so important in my life because I heard you sing it. But every time I sing it, I never sing it for anyone who is alive. I always sing it at a funeral. So it is my pleasure to do this song for someone who can hear it. Who can hear it? I'd like you to give Miss Westbrook a hand for me right now, please. Hold it, you gave her a foot. I said give her a hand. All right. The song is called When Beneath My Wings. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lorenzo Hawkins on keyboard. You ever known that you're my new?
get back, don't we?
Yeah, we do know.
We survived this whole.
We ever would have thought we'd be here.
And what's your name?
Virginia?
Yeah.
Good meeting you. A beautiful wife, yeah. Connie, there you go, Connie. Oh,
how you doing?
Good,
so
good.
Handsome.
Oh, yeah, he is. I like that beard.
Getting old, bro. Oh,
yeah,
great.
I like that.
This is my husband, Larry.
Oh, okay. What's your name? What's your name? Good meeting you. No, I don't know. You know, he's still out of Berkeley somewhere.
Yeah.
But I haven't talked to him. My sister, I think she's talking.
Hey, how you doing? Good.
Ethan and Joseph, where are you?
God's always had his hands around them, so when they leave them.